Let me come to you first, Sagarika. There was this huge expectation that there was this tape recording, apparently, of JDU leaders being approached to change sides. Do you sense that there's something explosive that is yet to be revealed? That there's a lot that Nitish Kumar has left unsaid so far.
Well, Vishnu, I think if you look at the numbers, the JDU and the RJD at the moment have a clear majority. It will require about 30 JDU legislators to cross over and join the BJP. There are reports, there have been reports all of today that those are the efforts afoot, but that's not going to happen in a hurry. Right. Remember, Vishnu, I don't think the BJP in Bihar is as much of a powerful party as it is in Uttar Pradesh or even as it was in Maharashtra. It's difficult to break the JDU at the moment. I think that there are these rumors going around, but I would say that the JDU and RJD at the moment are in a comfortable place in terms of the majority. Sure. In the house. And I think that, you know, for the eighth time, Nitish Kumar will be sworn in as Chief Minister. I think we can say about Nitish Kumar
quite easily.
He will easily be sworn in, and that he has no permanent friends or permanent enemies. Nitish Kumar only has permanent interests, and Nitish Kumar's interests are his own. So
right?
At the moment, you know, I think he's played his last dice. I think he's playing a survival game.
His last dice till his next dice. Hang on, Sagarika.
Yes, he's thrown the last dice. But where he's going to go next, we don't know. So where he'll be in 2023 or even early 2024, we don't know.
We know where he hopes he's going to be, but whether he's going to get there or not, we don't know. Hang on a second.
At the moment, he is where he is, but we don't know what he's going to do next.